Picture number 5. Taming the ox. Once one little thought arises, another follows. Adhere to awakening, and all becomes truth. Reside in ignorance, and all is unreal. This happens not because of the world, but only because of your mind. Keep a firm grip on that rope and do not waver. Not for a moment. Put down whip or rein, lest the ox wander back to dust and desire. Pull again and again, till it's tame and gentle. Of itself, it will follow, without bridle or chain. Days pass. Even the wild ox comes to hand and becomes a shadow to my body. How gratifying. Well now, you have finally caught the ox. But this ox will not do what you want it to do. That's why you have to train it and make it your own. That's what we mean by taming the ox. This is what is otherwise called post-satori practice. Kensho, or awakening, is our goal, but without any follow-up, Kensho amounts to nothing. You must tame that ox, which you work so hard to catch. For us, training and practice continue right up until we die. We ourselves must each tame and train our own ox. We should not expect to be watched over by a teacher. The most important chapter of the 10 ox herding pictures is this one, Taming the Ox, where you sit down and chew the cud of satori, fully appreciating its texture. Thank you. One little thought arises, another follows. If even the slightest little thought should arise, then one after another, endlessly, other thoughts arise. As soon as one thought fades, the next thought arises, and when that one fades, then another one follows that. We call this being lost in samsara. When you do zazen, then you realize how full of unreal thoughts the human animal is. Ordinary people are out working, so they carry on their daily lives without thinking that their own unreal thoughts are unreal. But try doing a little zazen, and you will realize how full of unreal thoughts humans are. Such unnecessary, useless thinking. Such mental waste. You think things that you do not have to think. This is like letting an engine run idle, or leaving the lights on. Adhere to awakening, and all becomes truth. Reside in ignorance, and all is unreal. If once you cut right through unreal thinking, then that world we call awakening or enlightenment is revealed. Seen from the world of awakening, you can grasp the true nature of things. People in the world at large think they are seeing things truly, but really, they see just the shadow of things. They look at things through their many wants and desires, through that self-interest that says, me, me. Going through life only looking at things through their own personal experience, they have lost their grip on what is true and real. Since their hearts and minds are full of unreal thoughts, the world that they see is of course unreal. This happens not because of the world, but only because of your mind. True and false do not exist in the world out there. depending on whether the mind that looks out on that world is awakened or deluded, the things of the world are true or false. The moon neither weeps nor smiles. I gaze at the moon, sad for the thousand things, though it's not my autumn alone. When you are lonely in heart and cry from sadness, then too the moon cries. And when you are laughing inside, the moon too laughs. Thinking all this is my world, I gaze at the moon, thinking nothing is amiss. When you are full of spirit, then the moon too will appear full of spirit. Things in themselves are neither true nor false. They are neither sad nor happy. There is nothing so important as water. But even though you cannot live for one day without water, if you get swept away in a flood, you will feel that there is nothing so terrible as water. Water itself is neither good nor bad, but people see it as good or bad, depending on their particular situation at the time. Search the world looking for truth, but there is no truth in the world. It arises only from the heart mind. When the heart mind that is looking is true, then the world also is true. When the heart mind that is looking is false, then the world being looked at also becomes false. What is it for you to always be true? It is a matter of ridding yourself of thoughts. The true state of being of the human person is no idea, no thought consciousness. It is no mind consciousness. The true nature of our heart mind is a mirror-like spotless condition, unmarred by even a single thought. The many unreal thoughts and ideas we have are images cast upon this mirror. No matter how much you search there for truth, there is no truth there. Our original nature is that condition like a spotless mirror where, fundamentally, there is not one thing. Those who come into contact with a person of such consciousness are all themselves helped. If you yourself are no mind, then without you saying or doing anything, people who come into contact with you will take away some of that no mind. This is how Zen helps people. When a single beautiful flower blossoms, those who look upon it become gentle and calm in feeling. When a single individual attains awakening, those who come into contact with that person also awaken. They too are saved. This is what is meant by saving sentient beings. Keep a firm grip on that rope and do not waver. Catch the ox's nose line and keep a firm grip on it so that you never waver from mindfulness. Do this and there will be no faltering. To waver is to falter. To hesitate. Right from the start, leave no room to insert any doubt or discrimination. Moment to moment, no mind. Just advance straight down this path, and you will be all right. To maintain this consciousness, to proceed in moment-to-moment mindfulness is what is meant by taming the ox. Post-satori training requires complete absorption in mindfulness practice. Those who have not seen their own true nature, who have not attained satori or awakening, can do nothing but stir up more unreal thoughts. Not for a moment put down whip or rein, lest the ox wander back to dust and desire. This says, keep a firm hold of the nose line with one hand, hold the whip tightly in the other hand, and do not for a moment let go of the ox. If you are careless, the ox will go and hide itself in dust and refuse. If you let one thought through, then that one thought will cause another to occur. If you let your attention waver, this ox will run off somewhere. Do not let down your guard. Allow no openings. Keep a tight grip on that whip and line. Pull again and again till it's tame and gentle. As you train the ox, pulling with the rope and beating with the whip, gradually it becomes tame. That is, train the ox by pulling with the rope of meditation. The ox will become gentle and docile and will do your bidding. It becomes well behaved and will not run away. Standing or sitting, clearly the ox, Buddha nature, is there, self-aware. Of itself, it will follow without bridle or chain. When the ox has been tamed, though you do not use the whip or the line, It will always follow you like a well-trained dog. Though you forget about all koans, you will always be in no mind. You will get so that you will always be just there, blank, thinking of nothing. You must take the training of the ox to this point. You must train the ox so that you will not lose Kensho, so that you will not lose Buddha nature. Somewhere in the record of Rinzai, Rinzai's NG says, "Don't continue on with thoughts that have already arisen, and don't arouse any that have not yet been aroused. Just this will be worth far more to you than 10 years of pilgrimage." Don't let thoughts that have already arisen lead you off. Let them pass away untouched, just as they have arisen. And about those thoughts which have not yet arisen, it is unnecessary to think, "I must not cause them to arise." If you concentrate on letting go of all thoughts which may rise without grasping onto them, this will be more useful than 10 years of half-hearted monastery training. Days pass, even the wild ox comes to hand and becomes a shadow to my body. How gratifying! With day after day devoted to training and practice, the ox, the heart mind that always wants to get lost, even this ox will come to follow you around like your shadow. It is truly a great pleasure when you know that you can always savor the world of no mind in this way. There is no pleasure as great as this. But remember, it is days pass. It is not a matter of just 1 or 2 days spent trying to tame the ox. It is not a matter of a mere 5-day session. You must live in continuous concentration on mindfulness, in samadhi, never letting up even once. So I put this one request to you. Get into koan samadhi. Keep a firm grip on this line and concentrate on correct mindfulness.